Hello everybody, Mr. LEGOLOVER55 here, and today we'll be taking a look at set number 70651, the LEGO Ninjago Throne Room Showdown. This set is recommended for ages 6 to 14, retails for around $20 USD, and has around 221 pieces. So, let's get building. Now this set isn't depicting any specific scene from season 9 of the TV show, so the throne room itself is unfortunately non-canon. The closest thing the build reminds me of is the Garmadon Resurrection episode from season 8, mainly because Lloyd is captured in this set. Although the build of this set is non-canon, the minifigures fortunately are. There's a total of 5 minifigures included in this set. Lloyd comes equipped in his new suit for Hunted. One thing that disappoints me is his face print. In Season 9, his eyes are black to indicate the loss of his power. His eyes here, however, are green. This is most likely because LEGO didn't feel it was necessary to make a new face print for him. This version of Lloyd doesn't include his mask, but it does have his hairpiece. His two accessories include a pair of handcuffs and his sword. He has some very detailed front and back torso printing, as well as leg printing that makes him look like he's prepared for survival. This applies to Nia as well. Unlike Lloyd, Nia's new suit comes equipped with her two-piece mask. Her weapon is a spear that has a tassel piece on the end. The Skylar figure in this set is amazing and is definitely a huge step up from what we got in the Elemental Masters minifigure pack. She's equipped with tons of weaponry, including a ZX armor piece in black, as well as two black katanas and a pair of silver shurikens. She also reuses the Batman utility belt, recolored in red, which I think makes up for the lack of leg printing. Samurai X, aka Pixel, looks awesome as well. I'm really liking the choice of colors used on the suit. One thing that I'm sort of disappointed with this figure is with the face print. Something about it looks off. I thought LEGO would have learned from Coco not to print bright colors on a black minifigure head, but I guess not. The roughness of the printing on her isn't as bad as Coco's, but it's still something that bothers me a bit. Haruma's minifigure looks great, and I love how accurate it is to the show. One thing I was unaware of before I got this set was that her hairpiece is made of a rubbery type of plastic. Normally, I'm not a fan of rubber hair or hat pieces, but I think it really works in this case, because you can make the hair look really dynamic like it does in the show. Now, as for the build of the set, it's non-canon, but it's still a nice build. You have this throne in the middle for Harumi to sit on, which I think looks very nice. It's big, but not too oversized. It's just big enough to fit a small secret compartment that hides a sai and a gold key to open the cell. The cell Lloyd's contained in can open up and close very simply using some droid arms. I find it interesting that the designers chose to use katanas as the cell bars and not some staff pieces. I guess they wanted to include a lot of katanas in this set because there's a whopping total of 13 katanas in this set. 6 in black, 6 in gold, and 1 in red. In the third section of this set, there's an entrance that's blocked off by this cool piece that was introduced last year. You can have one of the figures break through here since the piece is connected by a 1x4 jumper plate. Next to that, you have a clip that you can attach Lloyd's sword to when he's locked up in the cell. And above his entrance, there's a security camera watching over everything. But overall, that's everything there is to the set. So overall, the main selling point of the set is definitely gonna be the minifigures. While the build of the set is nice and is a neat little display and play piece, the fact that this set has harder to get minifigures and an exclusive one is going to be the main reason people want this set. The price to part ratio is pretty decent as well, and the fact that there are 5 really detailed minifigures in this set makes it even more worth $20. Even though this set is all about the minifigures, I really love all the little play features the designers managed to cram into each section of the build. Overall, I have no complaints about this set. The build of the throne room, and especially the throne, is great for a $20 set, and the minifigures in this set are fantastic. I highly recommend this set if you are a minifigure collector, and I would say this is a must-have set for Ninjago fans. So those are my thoughts on this set. Let me know what yours are down in the comments below, and also let me know if you would like to see more of my reviews in this style. But anyways, that's about all I have to say, so I hope you guys enjoyed this video, thank you for watching, and keep building!